I don't know if I'm gonna finish today, but I'm gonna take my time because I want you. Because you, when you hear this message, it's gonna all make sense to you. And this is where a lot of people go wrong. I don't think people don't love God today.
Amen.
I think people are skeptical, and I think a lot of people have been hurt by life situations and other people.
Amen.
So they learn not to just trust nobody or trust
Amen.
Nothing.
Amen.
So that's what the Lord showed me this morning. Trusting God is better than understanding God. Trusting God is better than understanding God. A lot of people don't like to trust in things they don't understand. And that's what the problem is. The Bible said no man has seen God at any time except Jesus Christ, the only begotten of the Father. Moses seen a theophany of God, and he saw God in a burning bush, but he didn't see God. So no man can look upon God and live. Amen? And so, since a lot of people don't understand God and the things that he allowed to happen outside, they don't trust him. And that's where you get in trouble, because you have to trust in him. Our opening scripture is so simple and plain, it says it better than I can say it. Psalms 118, verse 8, when you finally say, bless his name. That's our opening scripture. Psalms 118, verse 8. If we don't trust God, we definitely not going to trust the scriptures. But we got to learn to trust God and his word. Amen? When you learn to trust God and his word, you're going to be a lot better off.
Amen.
Psalms 118, verse 8. And he finally said, bless his name. Look what it says. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in what? It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. May the Lord add a blessing to the hearers and doers of his word. Trusting God is better than understanding God. We got a lot of believers, they trying to understand God. And since it don't make sense what's going on and the things he requires of me and the things that he allowed to happen sometime, I'm not going to serve him. And that's where we get in trouble. God never asks you to understand him.
Amen.
He asks us to trust him.
Amen.
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 Watch this. We live in a world where trust has been diluted to meaning nothing.
Amen.
Many of us have trusted in people, persons, ethnies, all kind of things, and yet it let us down. It failed us. It didn't meet our expectation. So we live in a society where we see that trust has been diluted to meaning nothing. People will write a contract and break their contract. That's the times we live in. Lawyers will take your money and won't represent you. So we live in a society where trust has been diluted to meaning nothing. So when it comes to trusting in a God that we cannot see and have not seen, we think he's the same way. Trusting is placing hope or faith in someone or something. That's what God told me trusting is. Trusting is placing hope or faith in someone or something. But in society today, things that we can trust has failed most of us.
Amen.
But in society today, things that we can trust have failed most of us. Now let me give you Webster's dictionary of the word trust. The word trust in the dictionary means a firm belief in a reliability. A firm belief in a reliability. Truth, ability, or strength of someone or something. A firm belief of a reliability. You know, that Duracell battery, make that commercial. It goes on, takes a licking and keep on ticking, Duracell. And we trust it because they put a little stupid rabbit up there beating the drum. And the commercial ain't about 10 seconds. But they tell you he can beat the drum for 24 hours. And so we learn to trust it. When we get them batteries, we find out they only last about a month. Then you gotta, and then like they, and then they come up with the lithium, whatever those kind of batteries. And we say, well, this battery's better. They even make cars. Now they trust so much in batteries now, they even make cars operate strictly on batteries. So what I'm saying is we learn to trust things that have failed us. And so when it comes to trusting God, Because we have been hurt before, because we have put our trust in something or someone.
Right.
It's hard for us to trust God because we don't understand what he's doing. So trusting God is better. We live in a society where most of us have trusted in something and it has failed us. We look at our judiciary system. The courts have sent many people to jail that was guilty. I mean innocent and not guilty. And they have let many people go that was guilty and not innocent. Because you know why? Because man is operating all of these organizations. We look at our police departments all over the world. Many of us don't trust the police. Some of us don't even trust our neighbors. Some of us been hurt by our husbands, our wives. Some of us been hurt by our children. Some of us been hurt by our spiritual leaders. You look at how the priests and pastors are doing, ain't just Catholic priests. The Baptist priests, the non-denomination, all the preachers have done wrong. We have heard, we don't trust the preacher. Some of us been hurt by our boyfriend, our girlfriend. Some of us been let down by our banks, some of our jobs. Some of us even been let down, we don't trust our mailman. Can't deliver the right mail. I got to call the post office. I got to do this. In other words, what I'm trying to say, anytime a human being is in charge, you're going to get let down.
Amen.
Some of us have trusted things that were not human. Some of us trust in our pets. You got more people being attacked by their pets. Y'all look at SeaWorld, that whale killed that woman. That whale drowned that woman. And he knew what he was doing. Because every time he get close to the surface, he pulled her back down. But she trusted him. And he had a history. And she had a history of doing it to other people. So what they do, they transfer the whale to another park. That whale had a history of doing that. But these people somehow trusted this whale that she wouldn't do it no more if they just train her. And, you know, that whale had killed before. And SeaWorld knew about it. We have had people that got mauled by lions in the circus. They just got a new trainer. They said, well, he just was agitated. But we trust in the lion.
Amen.
So much that we'll just get a new trainer and the show must go on.
Amen.
So much trust in nature. We say, they tell you, the rain coming. They say, well, I'm going to stay in my house. I don't believe it's going to flood. And it floods. All kind of things we trust in. And it has failed us at some point or another. So when it comes down to trusting God, we stagger. We doubt. We hesitate. Because we have been programmed not to trust to a certain extent. We've been programmed not to trust. We send our kids to school and we say, well, we used to say you can stay after school. Not no more.
Amen.
Oh, I'm picking you up. You coming home, and you know what's going on in schools.
Amen.
We don't need to name nothing, because we already know. It's all over the world. It happens so much now, people don't even go, oh. Can you imagine when the first time you heard about that? You said, oh, who was the teacher? Now when they happen to say, golly,
Amen.
You just flipped the channel to something else.
Yep.
You can't trust the teachers no more. You used to. So now when it comes down to us trusting in God, we stagger, we doubt, we hesitate, because we have been programmed to not trust to a certain extent. But God wants to remove that when it comes to him. He understands how you not trust people. The Bible says, try every spirit to make sure they're of God. But I have the solution and the answer today on why we should continue to trust in the Lord versus trying to understand him. Don't try to understand God. Trust God. One of the number one reasons why you can trust God is because God is not a man that he should lie.
Amen.
He's not going to lie to you.
Amen.
How do we know that? Numbers 23:19. Look to your neighbor and say, we're going to move quickly today. You know you got to trust God. You're trying to understand God.
Amen.
Nowhere the Bible commands you to understand God. Numbers 23:19. Help your neighbor when you finally say blessed name. Numbers chapter 23, verse 19. God is not a man that he should lie. And if he won't lie to me, I can trust him. If you know somebody won't lie to you, you should be able to trust him. Numbers 23, verse 19. Look what it says. God is not a man that he should what?
Lie.
Neither the son of man that he should what? Repent. Had he said it, shall not he do it. Had he spoken it, shall not he make it good. Do you see that? Repent means he ain't going to turn around away from it. If he said it, he going to do it.
Amen.
That's why you need to start trusting him. If he promised you something, he going to fulfill it. He also encouraged us again in Isaiah. He said, just like when it rains, it fertilizes the ground and the fruits grow thereby. Once it rains, the ground soaks up the rain. The rain can't go back up to the sky. And God said, so does my word, just like that rain. When I send my word forth to do something, it accomplishes that which I send it to do. Just like when it rains, the ground soaks it up. It's only in the ground. And it fertilizes everything around. Let's look at that in Isaiah. We know God cannot lie, so that ought to build your trust in him. And then when he sent his word to do something, it does not return to him and say, I could not accomplish. How do we know? Let's look at Isaiah 55:10. Isaiah chapter 55. When you find it, say, bless his name. Isaiah 55:10. I got the solution and the answer why you should trust God. I'm giving you scriptures to help you. I trust him. I just take him at his word.
Amen.
You need to have childlike faith. What is childlike faith? If you put your child on the table and say, jump to daddy, that baby going to jump. Don't even know if you're going to miss him. Let him fall.
Amen.
And that's the kind of faith we need to have. Childlike. Whatever God tells you, just do it. But if you can't do that, let me show you why you should do it. Isaiah 55, verse 10 and 11. Look what it says. For as the rain cometh down and snow from heaven, return not thither, but water the earth. The rain and the snow, once it falls, it don't go back up. But it watered the earth and make it bring forth bud, that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater. It's going to do what it came to do.
Amen.
That rain going to take care of your heart. So shall my word, verse 11, be that go forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, that means without fruit, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the thing where I send it to. So you see, he said, just like the rain accomplished, my word going to bring me back my fruit.
Yes.
It's going to prosper wherever I tell it to go prosper. That's why you can trust me, God says. Jeremiah, he told Jeremiah, the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah. Is there anything too hard for God, Jeremiah? Is there anything too hard for me to do? Let's look at that. I got to show you these scriptures. Jeremiah 32. Isaiah, then Jeremiah. Just keep going to the right. Isaiah. Jeremiah, I'm sorry, 32. When you find it, say, bless his name. Jeremiah 32, verse 26 and 27. Jeremiah chapter 32, verse 26 and 27. Trusting God is better than understanding God. And these are the reasons why I'm showing you in the word that you should trust him. Jeremiah 32, verse 26 and 27. Then came the word of the Lord unto Jeremiah, saying, behold, I am the Lord, the God of all flesh. I made everybody. Is there anything too hard for me? I made the humans and the animals, the trees and everything. Anything that move or have any sort of life in it, I'm the God of all flesh. Is there anything too hard for me? If it is, tell me. That's why you can trust him. Listen, there are no limitations on his power or his authority. God cannot fail you. He can do all things. He is in total control of everything. He can allow or disallow things to take place in the world. He is not limited on his power or his authority. There's nothing too hard for God. With men, things are impossible. But with God, all things are possible. How do I know that? How do I know that God is able to do whatever I need him to do for me? Because the Bible said he can do exceeding and abundantly and above all that you ask or think.
Amen. Amen.
According to his riches and glory in you, though. Trusting God is better than understanding God. I may not understand everything he does. I may not understand everything he allows. But I need to trust him.
Amen.
Ephesians chapter 3. Look to your neighbor and say, he's given us a lot of scriptures to help us. Ephesians chapter 3 verse 20. Ephesians 3:20. Ephesians chapter 3. Verse 20. Ephesians 3:20. Look what it says. Now to him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all we ask or think, according to the power that working in us, he can do abundantly above all we ask or think. Abundantly and above. Do you see that? Ephesians 3:20. Trusting God is better than understanding God. Now watch this. He does not always intervene with most things because man has made it clear to God that he wants to be independent from God. He does not always intervene and with most things, because man has made it clear to God that he wants to be independent from God. We made it very clear to God as a people, not everybody, but most of us. Some of us, and so I gotta say some of us, because it's gonna affect all of us. Nobody should not be at church today unless they got a valid reason. Now, I can't judge. The pastor don't have no right to say you shouldn't be at church, because God don't want to see what you're really doing.
Amen.
And even if you're doing something for somebody else, God can only see, God is the only one that can see your heart.
Amen.
So the reason why you should come to church, not because the pastor said, because God said, forsake not yourself from the assembly, because here's why I'm going to power you and give you a word. So if you got a valid reason not to be here, then God says, okay. But if you don't have a valid reason, you showing God you want to be independent from his trust and what he says. Because we don't tell God we don't want, don't get involved in my business. We show God.
Amen.
If you invite me over for dinner, when I get to your house, you got the front door locked. You don't want me to eat no food.
Amen. Amen.
You invited me, but you got me locked out.
Amen.
And you won't open it up, and you said I'm knocking.
Amen.
So what that tells me? You don't want me to eat your chicken. So we don't tell God, stay out of my business. We show God, don't get in my business. And God can understand, because he knows, he understands what you mean. Because you show him through your actions that stay out of my business. We don't want him in school. We don't want him in nothing. Just let's be real. We live in a society now where they still trying to pass. I never thought I'd ever see nothing like this here. A bathroom referendum. We so blessed, we got to tell people where to go use the restroom, man. We got to pass law. Think about what I'm saying. We laugh, but this is serious. We got to pass laws to tell a man and a woman, mama taught me how to use the restroom when I was a baby. But now they got to pass laws to tell people where to use the restroom. We're a sick society.
Amen.
That don't want God in our business. And he's not in our business. And look what we got to vote on where you go use the restroom now. And somebody gonna go to jail because they didn't go use restroom where they say you have to go use restroom.
Amen.
I see you go to jail for taking stuff, you're hungry. But when you go wee wee, come on now.
Amen.
That's the time we're living in. Because we don't want, we tell God we got this. And look how we got it. It's just all torn.
Amen.
A bathroom referendum is on the Congress floor right now.
Amen.
Sad. Because we tell God, I got this. We don't want you in our business. And God said, okay, well, I'm going to let you handle it. We don't want him to be a part of our society. We don't want his leadership or his resource until we mess everything up. Then we want to pray. Then we want to say, where was God? I'm finna close. the clothes now. Because I want that to stick with you. We live in a nation where our government got to tell us where to go to the bathroom. And we call ourselves the United States of America. And we got to vote to tell a man and a grown woman where they need to go use the restroom. And the media is to blame for some of this mess because it's been homosexual ever since I was in school and we didn't mess with the gay guys. If they were gay, they were just okay. As long as you don't ask me to bomb nothing. Amen. Nobody messed with the gays.
Amen.
Nobody messed with them in school. In college, you don't hear about nothing. The media just blow everything up.
Amen.
And they're really doing that, to tell the truth, they're really doing that to help men go in the women's restroom. And I'll prove it. You ain't gonna never see a woman that's acting like a man go use the restroom in a man's restroom. She ain't going in there. Because she already know them guys gonna say, okay, you won't be a man, we're gonna show you ain't like us. She not gonna worry about it. When she gonna use the restroom, she gonna still go where the women go. It's the men wanna get in the women's restroom. Whether you gay or not, it don't bother us. We grew up with gay. I had friends that was gay. It don't matter to me.
Yeah.
But the government getting involved in stuff that's not their business.
Amen.
One of my best neighbors, me and him was friends back when I used to smoke.
Amen.
We used to go get our stuff together and then go get some chicken wing. He understood me. I understood him. He still was human.
Amen.
And I hung out with him.
Amen.
That's his life, how he want to live.
Yes.
The government don't have no business in this.
Amen.
But because we don't want God, God said, well, I'm going to let y'all make your own rules. When the Bible clearly tells you what we need to do about gays and murder. We love to talk about gay people, but we don't talk about the murderers.
Amen.
And the thief. Yes. And the man that eat too much or drink too much. God say, neither one of them going to heaven.
No.
Not even a drunkard. No. You ain't gay, you ain't never stole nothing, you ain't never killed nobody. But the Bible say, the drunkard should not inherit the kingdom of God. You drink too much, you got to have the angels up there drunk. Read your Bible.
Amen.
But we want to pick out people's sin and pick on a certain group of people.
Amen.
See what I'm saying?
Amen.
It's a sin to complain.
Yes, it is.
You don't drink, you don't smoke, you don't get drunk, and you're not gay, but you complain. It's a sin. Do all things without murmuring.
Amen.
Be a lot of people think they're going up and Jesus is going to leave them right there.
Amen.
Amen. I'm finna close for the second time. We need to quit trying to understand God. Watch this. We need to quit trying to understand God and his actions and learn to trust that he has our best interests at the top of his agenda.
Amen.
And I'll give you a scripture to prove. He always got your best interests at the top of his agenda. Romans 8:28. We're going to read that scripture and we're going on. Romans 8, God always got your best interest at the top of his agenda. But I want you to see it for yourself. Don't you forget out of all the scriptures I gave you, don't you forget this scripture right here. If you don't remember nothing else, don't you forget Romans 8:28. When things happen that look like it's not in your favor, you need to rely on this scripture right here. If you love God, you cover. Look to your neighbor and say, if you love him, you cover. Romans 8:28. When you finally say, bless his name.
Bless his name.
Romans 8:28. Look what it says. And we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are called according to his purpose. If you love God, it's all working together for your good. Don't you worry, God got you covered. Ain't that what Romans 8:28 says?
Yes.
And we know that all things work together for the good to them that love God, to them who are called according to his purpose. May the Lord add a blessing to the hearers and doers of his holy word. Give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Amen. Trust God. Trusting God is better than understanding God.
Amen.
Maybe some